from Power Director, it's Dartsman's Key Secret Life. Please welcome your host. She is the first lady of Newcastle Gay Scene. It is yours truly, it's Dartsman.
Here's my key, philosophy. A freak like me just needs infinity.
Video. The subject is regarding obstructing and holding the doors on the Tyne and Metro. A lot of people don't seem to realise how dangerous it is. Thousands of commuters hear the beep warning that the doors are going to close, but it doesn't stop them from entering the trains when the doors are closing at the same time. I mean, it doesn't sound as bad as when the doors are held open, but I still wouldn't recommend that at the same time. Holding the doors open can cause damage, and it's normally young kids and teenagers who act daft and stupid on the Metro. I've seen loads of times drunks doing the same thing, and yes, £1,000 fine is the maximum penalty, but if it was me in charge, I'd double it to £2,000. You wouldn't stick your hands in the door of a bus, would you? Come on. But examples of people obstructing the doors involve a woman being dragged along the platform of a moving train with her hands stuck between the doors. And that could have resulted in her getting electrocuted in the tunnel or even decapitated. It's about time Metro bosses put their foot down with fining people, because not only do these types of things cause damage, but they get taken out of service and returned to the depot to be repaired. The best thing to do is to wait until the doors close and then wait for the driver to decide whether or not to open them up again. Don't be an idiot and attempt to board the train or even obstruct the doors, including out of goodwill. People hold the doors open for other common reasons, or there have been incidents of passengers using walking sticks, wheelchairs, prams, umbrellas, and even pets to try and prevent the doors from closing so that they can board the train at the last minute. That is not a good idea, people. It's good to see that Nexus are cracking down. So I'm going to show you some examples on behalf of Nexus. Please do not hold the train doors open. It's dangerous, causes delays, and can lead to a fine of up to £1,000. One man was prosecuted in order to pay costs, and so he bloody well should. Stay safe and be sensible.
This first clip is from an incident at Jarrow when a woman obstructed the doors with her arms. She got stuck and was dragged along the platform, with the passengers trying to help her. They activated the emergency door release inside the train so the woman could free her arm. The train stopped and she walked away without requiring assistance. This footage is from a similar incident at South Hilton. This is a clip of a woman at Haymarket who uses one of her walking sticks to obstruct the doors. If you take a closer look, you can see her walking stick trapped inside the doors. In this clip from Central Station, there is more than one person obstructing the doors. And a similar situation occurred at Pilo. The next piece of footage shows a passenger causing a delay at Monk's Eaton by holding the doors for a friend. Sometime in the next century, his friend eventually arrives. And finally, at Central Station, a woman tries to pry the doors open just before the train leaves. She gets her hand stuck. The train stops and she falls down as she manages to free herself. Stay safe on the Tyne and Wear Metro. That's it for this edition. Until the next time, goodbye.